This project started when the local hospitals were running out of personal protective equipment, the N95 respirators, the masks. It was known in the literature that single ply cottons and wools were not as effective as N95 masks, but nobody had asked the question, how many layers do you actually need to be as good as an N95 respirator? We wanted to find solutions from materials that were generally available to the public. Towels, sheets, shirts, anything you'd have in the house. One function of the mask is to absorb the wet aerosols that come from people's speech or their sneezes or their coughs. But another function of a mask is to prevent transmission. When a mask gets wet enough, when it absorbs enough liquid, you could imagine that the liquid could actually wick all the way through. And so it became clear that we needed also hydrophobic layers, or layers of fabric that don't like water, to act as a barrier. We had built the apparatus out of things that we already had in the laboratory. Filter bottle, hot glue gun, wax, an airbrush, and some wire. We made one trip to Home Depot. So the whole apparatus is mimicking somebody inhaling with a constant flow of air through the material and then being exposed to an aerosol from a cough or a sneeze. One of my colleagues, Professor Ming Su, said, well, he can make fluorescent nanoparticles about the same size and surface chemistry as a virus particle.
The nanoparticles with the fluorescent tag get pulled through the fabric by the vacuum and they land on the glass collection slide. We then examine it under the fluorescent microscope and see which particles penetrated the fabric. So if it's a poor barrier, we're gonna see a lot of those red fluorescent particles. And a material that's providing good protection, very few particles are gonna pass and the slide is gonna be much more black.
We ended up testing over 70 combinations of fabrics. We found that there were several answers that give you as good as or better performance as an N95 respirator. I take two layers of dense terry cloth and make that as the filter in a mask. As long as you have really good fit around your face, you'll get really good protection.